welcome to Oakfield Farm. Our neighbouring farmer has loaned us a very lovely Class Axion 800, I think it was. 870. With wide tyres. This is a borrowed vehicle, and we will be giving this back at some point, but we are not leasing it from the shop. We're leasing it from a neighbouring farmer who is aware of our troubles with the John Deere and has very kindly given us a shot of this. And I have also purchased a nice green pickup truck. It's not particularly in keeping with the map, but a classic pickup truck isn't overly uncommon in the United Kingdom. Kind of thing a farmer would have. In the back we do have a tow bar, or a tow pole, and a toolbox. This is the actual working toolbox. I did purchase that, and it is in the back of our pickup here. So we'll head over to our John Deere and go and tow it back to the farm. I have installed a good few extra mods and more realistic physics is one of them. So if I turn too sharp even in this pickup with the amount of weight of that tow bar, I will tip. As you can see, neither of these two things in the back here are controlled by the straps. What we'll do is we'll see what I mean. And we will just park both of these up here and put a toolbox. Cost us a pretty penny. It's broken already. Well, it's upside down. So we'll jump in class here. Turn off the hired worker. Now, this is the vehicle that we are going to use to tow the John Deere back with. So just turn it off for the time being. And lower my tailgate to pull this. Okay. Pulled the whole car there. So I'll just drop that about there. Jump back in here and lift the tailgate. I think I'll move this this car out of the way. I'll move it around at the back. So I do have quite a few mods. I'll not show them all off today, but I will show them all. There's a couple of mods I do want to take advantage of in this series, some of which I'm very excited about indeed. I do have the orchard trees now, which I think is very, very cool. Let's go first of all, put our beacons on, because they should be on anyway. We'll just connect up to this pole. The easiest place to see. We're going to it now. It worked before. Ah, that would be because I now have manual attaching on. That was not what I wanted to do. But yeah, we do now have manual attaching. I'm not 100% sure on how it works, so you have to bear with me on that one for a little bit. No, don't do that to me. Just, please just do what I ask. Get back in here. Move slightly so that it reconnects. What I will do is turn on the help window. I have no idea how to manually attach. Pick up object, throw object. It's not even picking that up. Okay, so just turn it around this way. Try and very carefully look between these two. attached toolbar. It is not working. I'm pressing Q and it's not working. Okay, so we'll come back to that. I will disable the manual attaching. In fact, I'll disable the creator tools. I don't exactly use it very often. I only use it when I need to spawn in workers. Shouldn't be telling you that, but I do also use it for the money cheat, being able to pick up heavy objects and such like. So if you just bear with me a second, I will jump cut back into the game. And it should be everything working now. I have disabled a creator tool, so let's give this another go. It does work there. How do I attach to the front here? This is actually still working, but I'm not really wanting it to. Yeah, wrong button. I do love pressing the wrong button. Oh, that's not what I want. Enter this and it will not let me attach it there. Let me just double check. Exit here, whenever I see helper settings, attach object X. There we go. Put my buttons on in this tractor. Hazards on this tractor. Come out of this tractor into here, put the beacons and hazards on. We'll drain the battery, but that's fine. Because I've caught in a tree. Into pickup. And what we want to do here is set it up to follow. Turn this back off because it just getting in the way. So back in our borrowed class Axiom 870, we will head down to the farm with our John Deere and team. Way like that. Not sure how slow we need to go to stop that happening. It does pull us around a good bit. I will reduce my speed on my cruise control down quite a bit. Clear the law. But this kind of crash into traffic. So is our pickup still following us? Is it just doing some random stuff where it's bouncing back and forth too? So just get this back down to the farm, park it up, and make use of this lovely class that we have a shop with. We now have manual attachment, which is that's an air of realism to the game. That's not good. Don't want things like that. I'll just drag it as quick as I can, it might stabilize it somehow. Might put us into a tree and cause another accident. This is a borrowed tractor, so we certainly don't want to crash it. It's going to cause it any damage either. But this is not good. And there's a sign there that we're going to hit. Fantastic. Towing is not easy. This may be down to the fact that we don't have other mods installed now, one of which is the more realistic gameplay. The reason for that is that the reason for that is simply because it adds another layer of physics to the game, which is no bad thing. Certainly not something you want to be told. But it has the most direct impact of fun. So I will park this John Deere up in the farm, and just to wait until mechanic comes out. If it is just completely gone. So I'll park it in here, like so. Drag this little toolbar up, and we'll put the toolbar near here too. So it's something I plan on using very often. Over the shed here. I can move it around by hand, which is actually kind of unusual, given that when I put it in the pickup, it basically tips the pickup. Not sure what happened there. I just throw it. That went far. Throw it again. Go there. I'm looking ever too used to them. I forgot to adjust the steering wheel. This tractor also features interactive control for the sunroof, which I think is quite cool. So if I change the camera, you see the sunroof is now open. This tractor isn't massively full on power. As a result, I believe that I have indicators automatically turn off with steering wheel position now, which is very good. A few times where I've left my indicators on all the time. So I find this pickup and more importantly I have a toolbox because I'm going to have to buy another one just because the pickup's crashed. Lost it. It can't be located on the map either. It is technically placeable. So the good thing about this mods that I have installed, or these mods that I have installed, is they add an area of realism to the game. As you can see there, the tractor nearly fell over. Which is what would actually happen, I expect. If I had extensive experience driving a tractor, but that's what I expect. For some reason, I think my pickup has crashed. Three of all things. And lo and behold, no toolbox. wonder if it will even start straight into that tree. I can never hire that one again. I'll just go and park this up at the road. Go through this left field here. No idea where it would have came out. I don't see it anywhere. But that's quite a distance that it went. As you can see at the bottom of the screen there, I do have another mod that tells me more details about the fields and things like that. So this was a sunflower field and it's been harvested. So I do wonder if when you hit this tree, if the toolbox kept going. I don't see it anywhere. I didn't really want to spend this video looking for a little black toolbox. I do also have the realistic fuel mod, which makes the rev count up here. It also lets you know your meters per hour. It just retraces steps and bounces some back and forth across the road, I expect. So if that's the case, I think I should be going out, which is unfortunate. Okay, I will just buy another one off camera. Use this gentleman's driver to turn around. If you're wondering about the little gold circles on the map, they are gold nugget locations. I have found, I think, 15 gold nuggets. This is dangerous. Ah, I almost made it. Be sure to provide the farmer that gave us this tractor some money for the extensive damages that I've put on it. Hopefully he won't crash again. Just like that old Range Rover type thing in the past, I don't know what that's meant to be. In the front it looks like a Range Rover, from the back it looks like a Fiat. So we'll pay attention to where we're going, we should be able to keep up now. It's not asking to follow someone who's bouncing back and forth across the road. We will go into the farm through the main entrance. Or the entrance I normally use, I don't actually think it's the main entrance. He's been able to keep up with us. This tractor, we did get a shot of it, but it just come off the field, so it's filthy. Very, very dirty indeed. We need to get out of here, get it sorted so I can get down and fix this map. There's a beautiful map, and my computer just doesn't do it justice. Park this up in here. Time to move. Because we don't actually need it right this second. It will be getting use, but we only have it for spring. Instead, we will be taking our pickup for a little drive. Along here, and we are going to actually be doing a bit of farm work for the first time in a few episodes. So we'll get this up to here, and in this episode I'd like to do a bit of work on this field. So we'll just park this here, might have gotten it stuck there. I think I kind of did actually. I'm not sure if that's in the game, but if you actually watch the wheels, you seem to get quite a lot of wheel spin. If you go into the field itself, it buries down as if we're getting stuck. That is actually really cool. Obviously not actually getting stuck. We'll turn this off here and we will run down to our big beautiful red class. I think it's a class, maybe a case. Can't remember. It's a case. Class is the green one. My mistake. So this is a wheat field that's been harvested. This is one that belongs to us. So we'll just lift this, start the engine. Reverse up the hill here. We did have a hired worker do a good chunk of this field, but he was actually taking ages. He was taking an age and a half. I'm not sure how plowing is with these new mods. May be completely different. Seems to be reasonable. We don't have any front weight on this tractor, but I don't think we need it 4, we might need it 9. But this field has a nice grassy island in the middle that we are almost at. Almost at, if I can miss any of this. The next pass should have us pretty much at it. There is a slight difference with this mod. Plowing becomes more of a hassle. It's harder to keep it going. Wheels are slipping like crazy. And fuel economy is heavily affected too. Stable there for a second. Just a second, mind you, but still. So we're not going to do too much of this on the sections because there has been quite a lot of plowing in this series so far. So we'll get a little bit of it done. I'm not entirely sure what to put in this field, but I do want something rather interesting in here. If you have any suggestions as to what I'll put in here, please leave it in the comments. And then what you'd like me to plant here. This is quite a large field. It's around 7 acres. 7.5 acres, I think. Could be wrong. Probably 9 acres. I think it's 9 acres. But it's quite a large field anyway. Whatever I put in this field, if we will have it ample amounts of, it's definitely an arable field. So, not much left to do here. I will be starting a new series of Farming Simulator any day now. And if it hasn't already been released by the time I release this episode, then the series that I wish to start is Thornton Farm. I'd like to do a series in that farm because I do like that farm. It's a map that has muddy areas in it. Very interesting. I do enjoy that. You can get your tractor stuck, for example. Just leaving your farm completely clouded in mud, which is always fun. This tractor is plenty powerful for planning, but as you can see, it does struggle going up the hill due to its new mod. So my plan is to just do a hover or two and get into that island area. Grassy section in the middle. We'll get into that so that our AI worker doesn't get completely confused and leave that field, which is actually what we have done. So we'll just go around here and turn that street. Fill up this side. I'm not sure if I can cut those trees down and plow through it. Not entirely sure I'd want to do that either, to be honest. It's quite a nice feature. Very different. Let's see what we do here. At least we'll just sort of go around the island. Loosely. Just so that only the edge of the field has been done. Mostly on it. I don't mind missing a little bit when climbing between the curve thinking that they're going to miss out. Some fields have normal ground temperature over the top of them. Extension is a very good mod. Most of the time the workers get it right. You can set them to do pretty much whatever you like. So like I said, most of the time they do get it right. Which is nice. Better than the standard workers, which, let's be honest, are more or less useless. Another feature of the more realistic mod is if you are carrying a heavy trailer like this plow and you go to stop, it won't happen straight away. You're not able to stop on a sixpence like you can without the mod. You will continue to go forward and potentially crash. But like I said, it is the mod is called more realistic. Game engine and more realistic game features, I believe the other part of it is called. So I'm saying it's still not 100% right, so I shouldn't be able to do this with a plow. But it is close. It does have the tractor engine struggling, which is nice. So even with a big powerful tractor like this, what I'm asking it to do here, I can't imagine any tractors would okay with that. Also makes trailers interesting. It's also quite difficult sometimes to deal with. They go snap side to side and react to gravity, which is increase fun. I just kept this little section going down and set the motor to it before he will finish okay for me. There's a few pieces of equipment we don't yet have. We don't have any kind of harvesters or anything like that. But not much left to hear now. So hopefully you're enjoying this series. I haven't milled the idea of that mistake I made with the John Deere too much. This is what I mean by more realistic mod. That's me on full mod, which wouldn't let me turn any sharper than that. And as you can see, our brakes actually locked up there, which is quite interesting. I've never had that before. And we're also sliding with the slope of the hill. We do very gently slide to the left. Attempt to reverse it downhill here. Probably not a good idea. Pretty sure that that's not something that most farmers would do, is reverse plow downhill. I'm going to try and make my videos a little bit more enthusiastic as well, because I do actually know that sometimes my content is a little bit dry, shall we say, and my commentary is a bit uneventful. The reason for that is I've never done anything like Twitch before, and this is me still in my first month of ever recording any game footage or doing anything voiceover. I've never had to do any kind of narrative at all. So it is a new experience for me, and not one I'm massively competent with, admittedly. But hopefully it does improve over time. If you have suggestions on that, please let me know. But as for this episode, that is all for now. I will continue the next episode on the following day. So if you're enjoying this series, please leave a comment with any suggestions you have for me. Like the video if you did like it. And subscribe to see more content like this uploaded on a very regular basis. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.